Well, it's absurdly late right now. I have never stayed up this late in such a long time. Like, it has been years. But I was laying in my bed and I just heard this voice. Something just prodding, poking, and demanding that I shoot this video over and over and over again. And I couldn't shake the voice. And I call that the voice of God. So when I hear it, take it as a demand. And I'm just obedient to the word. So here's the video. But yes, it's 3:14 a.m. right now. I got my coffee so I can get through this video and bring the energy that it needs. And I'm going to explain why I believe you need to separate yourself from society, family, to unfold your maximum potential, or at least stay disconnected to a degree. Because you cannot follow your truth and unravel your potential when you're wrapped up and consumed by outside chatter and outside noise. The more connected and the more intertwined you are with societal groups or with the crowd, the more you drown out that inner voice directing you to where you need to go in your own life for who you actually are. It is drowned out, and the minds you're taking advice from are shotgun minds. There's no single-minded focus. They don't even know what they're talking about. They're just shooting a bunch of nonsense, a bunch of faulty programming, a bunch of limitations, restricting thoughts that they have picked up from others. It's not necessarily even themselves speaking. It's accumulation of what they have picked up from everybody else over time. The more you are integrated and intertwined with all these societal groups, and the more things you partake in and the more connected to the web you are, the more you are drowning out your inner dialogue. You will conform yourself in many ways to appeal to the majority. You will change and alter who you were made to be to comfort others. And it will get to the point where you completely drown that inner voice with advice, opinions, and complete noise to where you are following other people's purposes. You are taking other people's advice that they're probably not even using themselves. So for you to hang on to what anybody has to say, if it's not from your inner self, if it's not from God, if it's not from your soul, don't hang on to it. Don't put your trust into it, because it's coming from an external source. What's made for you, the blueprint for you, what your soul needs is inside of you. You know what you need. So why are you asking other people? It's because you want them to agree with what you know to be true for yourself. You are looking for validation. Hey, this is what my soul wants. Do you guys validate that? You have to stop looking outside of yourself for the answers. The more ties you have to societal groups, the more limitations, doubts, double-mindedness, fears, confusion you will have when chasing your true purpose. The more contradictions, the more reroutes, the more misdirections, because your soul, your spirit, God is telling you this way, but somebody's opinion just popped up in your head. Somebody's advice just popped up in your head, and it's leading you to waste your energy, to waste your time veering off in a direction that was never intended for you. For one to find his true purpose, he needs to quiet the mind and be still. He needs to listen, not add busyness, confusion, and a bunch of noise to the mix. You need to be still, and you need to listen to that whisper inside of yourself. You need to hear your soul's command and what steps it wants you to take. Or the alternative route you could chase, and you could follow the noise and become another duplicate if that's where you believe your truth lies. I believe every great mind was an outcast who preferred silence over company, because great ideas and revolutionary thinking doesn't stem or come from the masses. Do you think the Wright brothers sparked the idea inside of their mind of flying a metal tube through the sky from a random guy in the pub or anybody in society? Do you think they got that information from anybody in society in their current generation who never seen or even knew what that was? Do those ideas come from the masses? Do you think Nikola Tesla got his ideas from the mass, or being crowded up and bunched up in that noise? Guaranteed they were constantly on the outside looking in, because society and their generation most definitely thought they were batshit crazy. And if they would have brought any of those ideas up in a normal societal setting, they would have got shot down, they would have got mocked, and we wouldn't have airplanes if they were crowd body. Because what voice, what direction do you have when your mind is busy, when you have all of these opinions, when you're constantly flooded with information by other people of what your life should be, where you should move, which step you should take, their advice for your life? What voice do you listen to? By being in societal groups, you are overcrowding your mind and clinging on to ideas and thoughts, pathways that weren't designed for you. You have to be outside of the box to influence anything inside of the box. Because if you're inside the box, you have the same thoughts, the same beliefs, the same limitations. You're scared to have different opinions, different beliefs, different ways of being because you're scared of judgment. When you're inside the box, it's damn near impossible to influence anything inside of the box because everybody thinks the same. It's a hive mind of people who don't want to be different because they're scared of judgment. People who are pleasing other people, so they're really not themselves. They're putting on a front, and it's just this whirlwind of people following the same thing, being the same person, being the same spirit. When you have that conformed mindset of being in the box, you do the things that have already been done. Everything else is ridiculous until it is accomplished. Then they follow suit. They follow the footprints. They're not the ones making the steps in the snow. They're the ones following behind. When you are so deep in the web, you're a person pleaser. You fit in just a little too much. When you are deeply ingrained and rooted in that box, you only know what's in the box. You don't reach out for more because you don't want to be judged. You don't overexpand and feel discomfort from your group. Everybody relatively stays the same. They'll go a little beyond in the name of achievement, but going too much, too far is pushing you outside of the box. And that's the unknown. That's the uncomfortable. So you got to go back into the box. And when you're inside of the box, you're living a zoned, caged existence with parameters, limitations, and we call it fitting in. And that box is always looking for something new. The people inside of that box idolize, they applaud, they clap at the people outside of the box, the people who broke out of that zone. Those are the people with the YouTube videos that they watch. Those are the people with the podcasts that they watch. Those are the people with the music that they listen to. Those are the people they aspire to be. They can never be that person if they stay in those parameters. The more a man chases his purpose, the more he needs to disconnect from his environment. He will soon realize the safety net of care from his family is suffocating his growth and expansion. Family has the tendency to guard your actions and coddle your mind in the name of love. They want you to fit in, but they're extremely uncomfortable when you stand out. They want you to make enough noise to get by, to get that nice, lovely promotion at your job, but not enough noise where it's uncomfortable. And a coddled mind is the death of a man's spirit. Inside a man's heart, he desires more. He dreams of breaking past his limitations and fears once and for all. And if he doesn't, that weight and that fear, those limitations will haunt him for the rest of his existence. He needs challenge and growth. He needs something to chase like a lion chases its prey. It keeps him enthusiastic, optimistic, positive, and thrilled about life. And a man's spirit gains strength and character by overcoming adversities. And when these adversities have been overcome, it boosts his morale, it boosts his confidence. And the more he overcomes, the more doubt, fear, insecurity, negative thoughts lose their grip on his soul. And the less doubt, fear, and these negative emotions play a factor in his life, the more he can be the man who God designed him to be. And the only way a man can overcome these suffocating, soul-destroying, parasitic emotions is by overcoming adversities. And you will never overcome them by having a soft, coddled, nurtured mind. And to become an overcomer, you need God in your life. That is your strength. You got to realize where that power comes from. Family can suffocate by nurturing, coddling, and imposing their limitations and doubts on you. The more you grow and expand, the more their doubts, fears, and limitations will start to manifest. But what they don't realize is you overcame your doubts, your fears. They have not. The more you overcome, the more you expand, the more you grow. You will need to detach because at the start of your journey, guess what you had? Doubts, fears, limitations, but you were tested. You went through the trials and tribulations. You overcame. And unfortunately, a lot of people are comfortable, stagnant. They don't want to overcome. They can't figure that out. They are stuck in that cycle, that loop. They are grapes that have yet to be crushed. And if you are a grape that has been crushed and is ready to turn into wine, you don't want to listen to people who have yet to be crushed, who still hold on to fear, insecurity, limitation, because that just means they have yet to be crushed. Because when God lays his hand upon you, those emotions cease to exist because God is powerful. God doesn't fear. God is not afraid. You need to cut out the noise because you are listening to people who are seasons behind you. And their time surely will come. They just gotta ask for it and desperately seek for it and want to go for it, just like us. As men, we need to overcome, grow, and test ourselves daily. Stagnation is death. And guaranteed, your surroundings are filled with stagnating minds who want to suffocate your potential, unintentionally or intentionally. And if it's intentional, shame on them. God's wrath will come upon them, guaranteed. Because when it's your time and people want to intervene, they want to jump in front of you, you got to understand, you are not attacking me. You're attacking God. And when you are attacking or getting in the way of somebody who walks with God, you are not attacking that person. You are attacking God and the purpose he has for that person. And God cares about his people. So when you get in front of me, when you try to disrupt my path, you are up against God, and I can't promise that you'll make it out. And the same goes with any man with a purpose, because purpose is life. And life comes from God, and he wants you to live it in full. But yes, don't let comfortable, lazy boy chair, laid back, remote control minds have a say on your life, saying what you can and cannot do. The next time somebody judges you, limits you, talks bad about you, says something that is unpleasing, just look at them, analyze, and think in your mind, when I grow up, do I want to be that person? When you have the seed of more inside of your mind, a better life, becoming a better version of yourself, striving, pushing for more in life, why would you listen to anybody who wants to limit that or take away or who says less than what your own spirit, your own GPS system is saying? Feed that voice and disregard the rest. God knows you're ready for more, and that's why he planted the vision in your mind. Be grateful you have the vision of more, not the vision of I'm just gonna settle and stay stagnant. I'm on autopilot. Every single day is a cloud. I'm living in the muse. I got no ambitions for more. I got no drive for more. Be grateful that you do have the vision for more, and feed that void, because the people who are giving you advice, the people who are telling you what to do, they are stuck on autopilot. And the programming they are spitting to you is the reason their soul's in bondage. They are trapped in limitation. They are trapped in fear. They are in bondage. They are in chains, and they have not overcome themselves, but they have the audacity to try to give you advice or steer your boat and where it should be heading. You end up listening to the wrong people, and you will end up in the same position. You follow God, you listen to God, you follow nobody, and you trust yourself. Because God does not want you ending up like the majority. And that's why you have the seed, the vision of more. So why do you listen to them? Because when you go through tests, adversities, challenges, suffering, nobody is to be found. God was always there. When you chase that thing that gave you purpose, gave you life, gave you fulfillment, gave you ambition, gave you drive, gave you the motivation to strive for more, they laughed, mocked, spread limitations, trickled seeds of doubt, and offered no value. Perhaps some wanted to cut you down, but God wanted you to push past and go for more, to push further. God gave you the spark inside of your soul and your mind, and you'll soon realize people have intentions of dulling that spark. It's only a matter of time. It's only a couple seasons away where every man will show that he will fail you. Now, I'm not saying lose your morals and lose your love for humanity, but I'm saying God will never fail you, and this is why you need to detach and go with the person who will never fail you. Feed that relationship, feed that voice, build that connection, build that intimacy, because in the beginning, they'll feed doubt, they'll feed limitation. In the middle, they want to compete, throw you off, judge, condemn, mock, laugh, etc., etc., and in the end, they copy, steal, and follow. Man will always fail you. And David was a literal king with servants, and everyone was praising him, and everybody loved him, and yet everybody still turned on David. People will change throughout the seasons. They love you in one season, in the next, they're your enemy. The next one after that, they apologize. In the next one, you inspire them. People are always changing and flowing through the moods, through the energies of life. They're never through and through the same. It's never going to be the same like it is with God. God is always loving. He always has your best interest in mind. He always wants you to be the maximum version of yourself. And to connect with God, you must be alone and still. So detach and disconnect to be the maximum version of yourself, because your maximum version does not dwell in the crowd. Follow God, better lace the fours. Better cry, I'ma face the war. Son of God, I'ma praise the Lord. Hallelujah, I'ma praise the Lord. If it ain't God's will, I don't make time. I gotta read the word when I make rhymes. I gotta pray to God like I'ma FaceTime.